The shear strain rate can be defined as the rate at which the angle formed by two lines that are initially perpendicular to each other intersect at a point. To understand this definition, consider the following illustration. This is a fluid flow in a two-dimensional view. Let's just say, there is a square fluid parcel there. In this square there are points 1, 2, 3, and 4. Fluid parcels will flow along with the fluid flow. Well, each point on the fluid parcel may have a different speed. Thus, the four points are no longer square, but parallelograms. This means that some sides of the fluid parcel shift. This is what is meant by shear strain. To analyze this movement, connect point 1 and point 2 with a line. Likewise, point 1 and point 4. Well, initially these two lines intersect at point 1 and form a 90-degree angle. Over time, the angle at point 1 decreases. Well, this measure of angle reduction is known as shear strain rate. The shear strain rate is also symbolized as epsilon. It's just that the subscript is different. If the fluid is in the xy plane, then the shear strain is written as epsilon of xy, or epsilon of yx. These two values are the same. If the velocity field of the fluid is a vector v equal to ui hat, plus vj hat, plus wk hat, then the magnitude of epsilon can be written as one half of the sum of the partial derivative of u with respect to y and the partial derivative of v with respect to x. The greater the value of epsilon of x, y, the faster the angle in the fluid parcel decreases. By the same analogy, in the xz plane, the shear strain rate is epsilon of xz equal to one half of the sum of the partial derivatives of u with respect to z and the partial derivatives of w with respect to x. In the yz plane, the shear strain rate is epsilon of yz equal to one half of the sum of the partial derivative of v with respect to z and the partial derivative of w with respect to y. Hope it is useful. And, don't forget to watch the next video.
I like to be educated, but I'm so frustrated. Hello to my loneliness. I guess that ignorance is better.